Welcome back, Kim Sam here, and this is Teacher Kim's Korean class, bringing you informative lessons on social media. I'm uploading my lessons twice a week, like vocabularies, grammar, pronunciation, useful expression, just like this video. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. And in this video, I'm gonna be telling you how to read calendar and indicate dates, months, and years in Korean. I've seen many learners are confused of it because Korean language have two sets of numbers and many counting units. So in this video, I'm gonna be breaking down dates, months, and years in Korean, which is very useful. Are you ready? 출발! First of all, we need to learn the 7 days of the week in Korean to read the calendar. The days of the week, Monday to Sunday is 월요일, 화요일, 수요일, 목요일, 금요일, 토요일, 일요일. Right? Good. Now we are gonna put a date, month, and year. As I told you, there are two sets of numbers in the Korean language, Sino-Korean numbers and Native Korean numbers. And when you talk about date, month, and year, we basically use Sino-Korean numbers, like 1, 2, 3. You get the idea. If you want Sino-Korean number from the basic, push the link above to learn it. And Korean used three different counting units for indicating date, month, and year. I'll explain them one by one. When we read the date of month, we use counting unit 1 after the date number. The counting unit 1 is different with the Sino-Korean number 1. The character is the same, but the meaning is different. The counting unit 1 indicates the previous Sino-Korean number is the date of month. For example, 1일 means the first date of month, 2일, second, 3일, 4일, 5일, like that. And the 31st of month is 31일, right? If you can read Sino-Korean numbers 1 to 31, reading a date is not so difficult. You can just put 1 after the Sino number, right? But reading a month is a bit different. When you read a month of year, basically we put counting unit 월 to the month number, like 1월, 2월, 3월. But when you say 6 months, June, we don't say 6월. Nope. Instead, we say 6월, not 6월. 월, but 6월. And for October, we don't say 10월. We use 시 rather than 10. 시월. Not 10월, but 시월. Okay? 6월 is June. 시월 is October. Other months are easy. Just use Sino number and put 월. 1월, 2월, 3월, 4월, 5월, 6월, right? 7월, 8월, 9월, 10월, 11월, 12월. Okay? And for years, we put the counting unit 년 to 4-digit Sino-Korean numbers. This year is 2019. I'm recording this video in 2019. 2019년. Here is important thing. When you mention the date, month, and year in Korean, like reading calendar, you have to say the year first, 년 first, and the month, 월, then the date, 일. 년, 월, 일. That is the way Korean read calendar. Here is a calendar of 2019, and it is marked on 29th of October. Let's try to read this calendar. First, we read year with counting unit 년. Of course, we use Sino-Korean numbers. 2019년. And month. October is 10th month of the year. So is it 10월? No, I told you October is different. We read it 10월, not 10월. 10월 is right. And then date 29th, 29. And the counting unit 1. 29일. So the marked date of the calendar is 2019년 10월 29일. Does it make sense? Good. So now you can say your birthday in Korean. The year of your birth with counting unit 년 and the month number of your birth with 월 and date with counting unit 일. Can you do that? And I want to talk about birthday something more. You know the Korean word 생일, which means birthday, Actually, the word 생일 means the day of each year you celebrate the date of birth. So the meaning of the 생일 doesn't include the year of birth. If your Korean friends ask your 생일, you don't have to say the year of your birth. You can just let them know your date and month of birth. But if they ask your 생년월일, that means they want to know the year of birth as well. Can you see 년월일 here? Which means year, month, date. So 생년월일 means your date, month, year of birth. Can you understand the difference between 생일 and 생년월일? 생일이 언제입니까? That means what is the date and month of birth? But 생년월일이 언제입니까? Means what is your date, month and year of birth? Question of the day. 생일이 언제입니까? Leave your answer in Korean in the comment section below. Thank you guys. I will see you in the next video. 안녕!